月份就是我们今年的其中选举了。今天我非常荣幸邀请到了参选22选区参议员的伍国庆伍先生，跟我们讨论一下他的竞选理念还有参选情形。Hi Mike.
Hi Charlene. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. What a beautiful day today. Why are you picking this location?
You know, this is one of our wonderful parks. Monterey Park is known for its parks. We have 13 parks here, and a lot of young people use this to have recreation. A lot of our senior citizens come here and they have picnics with their families.
Yes, I saw actually some people doing Tai Chi over there.
Yes, that's right.
我从来不知道，其实蒙特利公园市就真的是有13个公园在蒙特利公园市里面。Wow, that's really awesome, especially it's such a condensed city.
Yes.
Another personal question I would like to ask you is about you and Judy. Everyone knows you guys are a very lovely couple. You know, how do you guys get along with each other?
We've really felt that we're so privileged. We've had the opportunity of having education.
Yeah.
And, you know, we felt that with given the opportunity of education and the opportunity to voice our concerns, that we really owe it to the community to serve the community and try to organize people to do something better.
Why would you like to run for the 22nd District Senator?
This is such an exciting opportunity at this particular time. You know, I have the experience. I accomplished what I think was, what others tell me is a lot in education and transportation, the environment, job creation and housing. Those needs are still here. And I want to go back and complete the job that I started. Number one. Number two, we face very challenging times.
We are.
We all have to step up and do our share. What's going on in Washington, D.C.? California has to be able to move beyond the issues that the president and his party is raising. And so that's why I feel that I'm equipped to do that. I have the experience. I served at three levels of government, the city council in Monterey Park, the state assembly, the community college board of trustees. And I think my experience will really help make a difference.
Okay, California, even though we're number one-fifth, okay, of one of the largest economy, you know, contributor. However, there are still 5 in 1 Californians that are facing poverty. How are we supposed to resolve that issue?
That's a really serious problem. When I served in the Community College Board of Trustees, I saw a lot of students living in their cars. A lot of people come up to me and ask me for borrow money for food. And I said, well, we better do a survey. In our Community College District alone, the largest community college in America, 250,000 students, 20% are homeless. Two-thirds go hungry every 3 days. What's the solution? We really need to look at housing. Housing's a major, major problem. I think the issue that happened is when Governor Brown was a great governor, but unfortunately he did away with redevelopment. Redevelopment was an issue where local communities had a very small amount of property tax that they could give to their local government for affordable housing. I want to bring some form of that back.
Right now, there is a rate showing that for community colleges, there's only 40%, maybe even lower graduation rate. Is there any possibility we can somehow bring up the rate?
Yes, we have to start way back in the first, second, and third grade to do college preparation. We need to bring lawyers, doctors, people that are engineers, as well as firefighters, nurses, bring them into the classroom and say, this is where we need to start raising the imagination for our young people, not wait until they're in the 9th or 10th or 11th grade. So that's number one motivation. Then two, the college preparation, what we call the AP courses, have to start very, very early. We can't wait until they're almost ready to graduate from high school to start those college prep.
Next question I would like to know. Are you residing in Monterey Park?
Yes, lived here for almost 40 years.
40 years. Monterey Park has changed so much.
Yes.
Right? And with more and more immigrants coming into Monterey Park, however, economy is going up and down. Have you been hearing any of the complaints, suggestions, or anything from the immigrants?
Monterey Park is such a wonderful city. It's a gateway city. A lot of our immigrant families move here and then they move further east. Monterey Park, as you know, was rated very, very highly by Money Magazine. But I think like every city, whether it's Los Angeles or Monterey Park or any of the other cities in the San Gabriel Valley, it has its strengths and its weaknesses. I think one of the major issues is how can we make small businesses flourish and thrive, you know, because they really are the heartland of why people come to Monterey Park and other cities. Our restaurants, our shopping areas. especially small businesses that want to innovate. A lot of our college students, when they graduate, they want to, even when they're in college, they're forming their own corporations. How can we make it more business friendly for them? That's number one. And number two, the housing is a major, major issue. Mm-hmm. I think number three is very, very important, is to make sure our school systems continue to thrive. Many people choose where to live because of the school districts, and Monterey Park has one of the best.
所以刚刚您提到的三个重点呢，就是您今年参选的三大政见了。三大政见呢，其实关于每一个人的切身问题。这个切身问题呢，不外乎就是每一个人的 business growth 要有成长。再来呢，就是每一个人要有房子住，而最重要的，也就是华人最关心的，就是教育问题。每一个人的教育学区要慢慢的被提升。如果您也关心您切身的问题，今年11月的中期选举，您一定要参与投票，让所有的人听到华人的声音。